Welcome back to Let's Play Snatcher Blind. I'm Amethyst Lunatari. Sure, we'll save. And now beginning Act 3. So the only one we didn't write is that one. Continuing with the investigation. I'm pretty sure this is the final act.
With the start of this year's Kyoto Summit just 3 hours away, the delegates from the participating countries are beginning to arrive at the conference center.
Act 3. Junk.
A major poll of domestic and international opinion, carried out just last week, shows that the vast majority of respondents favor a complete quarantine of Neo Kobe as a means to combat the risk of the Snatcher menace.
It's already been quarantined, though, hasn't it?
Now that the Chief's death has been confirmed, it won't be long before they strip us of our junker authorization.
They will be deciding how to handle Neo Kobe at the summit in just 3 hours.
There are rumors that they're going to use nukes on the city to make sure the Snatchers are wiped out.
Oh my god.
That's ridiculous. Come on, this is the 21st century.
That may not be as improbable as it seems. The world's leaders are extremely concerned about the Snatcher problem.
The Chief was going to calm this hysteria in his speech at the summit, but that'll never happen now.
3 months ago, government pressure on Junker operations increased dramatically. Gillian's transfer here was really our last chance.
Our own Chief was snatched. It's not too surprising they don't want to trust us anymore.
I've heard that the Army and FBI are going to take over operations now.
That's correct. That too will be officially decided in 3 hours' time.
It's the wrong country.
Is there any way we can find their hideout in that time?
If we don't, we and everybody else in this city are finished.
As far as they're concerned, we're just like a cancerous tumor that has to be cut out.
We have to hit the Snatchers' headquarters before then.
Gillian, can you do it?
If we only knew where it was, I should be able to manage something.
Hitting their outposts like Queen's Hospital won't do any good. We have to find their main nerve center.
What about the memory of that Snatcher who was impersonating the Chief?
Just like the others, it was completely blanked. It's a form of self-destruct mechanism that they use.
They didn't consider that.
Mental, what about tracing that video phone call from Jamie?
It was no good. The call didn't last long enough. Still, it definitely did come from within the city.
Damn. Where are they hiding?
Gillian, can't you remember anything at all? Didn't Jamie say something that implied you were somehow connected to the Snatchers?
Nothing. I can't remember a damn thing. Metal, I want you to tell me everything you know about me. Why was I sent to Junker headquarters? Where did I come from?
Yeah, give me level 7 clearance.
Gillian...
You have?
Metal, the Chief's dead. Tell me everything you know about me.
You have to.
Well...
Metal!
Alright. With the Chief gone, you are the highest ranking officer here.
True.
You knew all along?
Of course.
Where were we rescued from?
3 years ago, you and Jamie were taken into protective custody in the Siberian Neutral Zone by the 17th Siberian Investigative Force. More precisely, you were discovered in cryogenic sleep pods in an underground bunker near Moscow.
Yep.
Cryogenic sleep pods? You mean they were frozen?
This is a photograph of the bunker. There is no record of when you were placed there. In addition, the third pod was empty at the time you were discovered.
There were three pods?
You were revived and taken into custody by the army. Apparently, as a result of the extended sleep, both of you suffered from complete amnesia. However, another theory suggests your memories may have been intentionally erased. This is the only piece of evidence found at the site.
Harry.
That's Harry's picture, from when he was a kid.
He's the third one?
That's correct. Harry is Gillian and Jamie's son.
What?
It's been confirmed by DNA tests.
What?
Harry? Harry was my son?
He's older. Well,
using the information gained from the photo, it was established that you are Gillian Seed, and your wife, Jamie Lorraine. Both of you are American citizens, born in the late 1960s.
The 1960s?
How long are we in there?
In addition, both of you vanished without a trace in 1989. There is no other information available about you after that.
1989?
Yes. You come from a world that's been gone for 50 years.
But what does that have to do with the Snatchers?
Wow.
When the 17th Special Investigative Force was bringing the two of you out, there was an accident. Though the two of you were all right, most of the 17th was killed. One of them was a Snatcher. Of course, before their departure, they all underwent thorough examinations. So, if one of them was snatched...
It had to be somewhere in Siberia, right?
That's correct. And in order to attempt to determine the origin of the Snatcher, as well as your true identities, you were assigned to Junker Headquarters. The hope was that exposure to the Snatchers would help you regain your memories.
Moscow? 50 years ago?
I think we created
Almost
them.
Everyone who was in Moscow at the time was killed in the catastrophe.
So Gillian and Jamie are the only living witnesses?
Harry. Harry was my son.
That's crazy.
Did he know?
No. It was highly classified information. He was never told.
That's so sad.
I was never able to do anything for him.
Oh.
Wait a minute, Gillian.
Everything's
Didn't
a sad.
Did Jamie say something about taking a boy hostage?
That's right. They must know about Harry and are using him to threaten her.
We have to find their headquarters quickly.
We've only got 3 hours.
Gillian, let's think this all through again. We...
Okay. Hopefully this works while I'm doing this. Because Harry did say that he was talking to Gillian, right? And by talking to Gillian, he felt like... He was completely comfortable, like he never was before, that he found it really easy to talk to Gillian. That's one thing. Now, Harry's older. He must have been... Was he born in... He must have been born and then we went into the pod. Right, so that's why he was older, but... Or was he in the pods with us and then released sooner? I don't know. Just thinking out loud.
May get some kind of a hint out of it.
You're right. There may be some clue in the way they're operating.
All right. Let's go over what we know about them.
Well, I could have just waited till now. I had no idea how long that cutscene was going to go on for. It's Kojima's cutscenes. Basically, all starts here. First of all, what's the Snatcher's weak point? Metal Gear says. What if I give a wrong answer? I know it's ultraviolet rays. I just like seeing responses to things. What if I say cold? This is the Snatcher's weak point? Gillian, don't mess around, Mika says. Think carefully about it before you answer, Gillian. Alright. Ultraviolet rays. That's correct. Their weak point is their defective artificial skin. Long-term exposure to ultraviolet rays causes mutations in the melanocytes in the stratum basal of their skin. Oh, it could have also said sun's rays. That was another option. The basal of their skin, which become cancerous. Specifically, long ultraviolet rays in the 250 to 350 nanometer range is responsible for causing the cancer. That's right. And that's the reason why they are so limited as to when they can be out. We know Siberia, it's always cold. Perfect place for them. Always cold, snowy. They only come out at night in the middle of the winter and wear sunscreen even then, Gillian says. Mika says that's the method that Jean used to figure out what the Snatchers are up to. How ironic. It turns out the destruction of the ozone layer actually had a benefit for us humans. That's right, Metal Gear says. Now, what method were they able to move and be able to avoid ultraviolet rays and sunlight at the same time? Underpass? It's the tube. The train, subway. I guess here they're calling it underpass instead? That's right, they were using the abandoned tunnels of the old tube liner system to get from place to place. Should just put tube liner system. That's how they were able to move around without being noticed. Nielsen's apartment, the old factory, Queen's Hospital, all of their hideouts were connected by the tube liner. Okay, so you just have to track the tube liner, see where else it goes. So maybe there is a tunnel under their main base as well. There's a good chance of that. Next, what phenomenon was always observed at any location where Snatchers appeared, including the underground tunnels? Snow 9. Oh. Yeah, hiccup. No. Sneeze from Snow 9. This is the phenomenon you're talking about? That's right. What was the cause of the sneezing? Snow 9. You're correct. The sneezing was caused by the presence of the allergen Snow 9, Metal Gear says. Snow 9 is an artificial form of pollen developed by the military, and its presence is limited to certain regions. Gillian says they were using it to interfere with radio transmissions and keep people away. They probably were producing it intentionally themselves. Metal Gear says the only regions of the city where Snow 9 is still present are areas around the Ina River. It has been cleared out of other areas because of the danger it presents. So that means that their base must be somewhere near the Ina River, right? Yes, and near the tube liner. Near some kind of access to the tube liner. That's a fair location. They are probably somewhere near the Ina River, protected by the Snow 9. Accessible to the tube liner and near the Ina River. And you must not forget the three photographs that we found the Snatchers with. All of them were related to the Soviet Union before the catastrophe. The map on the wall of Nielsen's apartment. The picture of the temple in director's office at Queen's Hospital. The photo of Red Square hidden in the chief's office. Why do the Snatchers keep pictures and memorabilia like this? Maybe they're homesick? Maybe that's where they come from. I don't think the Snatchers have emotions, if possible. Homesick? Get serious, Mika. They're robots, you know? Yeah, that's exactly my reaction. Let's analyze this a little closer. What city is related to all three of these pictures? Moscow. This is the city they have in common. That's correct. It's Moscow, Metal Gear says. Gillian says, Moscow must be where they come from. That must be the basis of their programming. You might be right. Just as people have a hometown that is dear to them, their creators may have put a hometown into their programming. They use very advanced artificial intelligence systems, so they may have needed something like that to maintain their emotional balance. Really? Emotional balance? Yeah. They were born out of nothing, but they needed to give them some kind of image as an emotional base. So Moscow is their creator, and their home. And the place that they found Jamie and I.
This homing instinct thing of theirs has led them to set up their headquarters in some place that reminds them of home, or their creator.
What part of this city is like Moscow?
Moscow's really cold, right? They get a lot of snow, don't they?
Snow?
No snow has been recorded in Neo Kobe in several years.
Well, then that's not it.
Ski resort?
Wait, what about that pollen? That crystal bioengineered stuff, Snow 9?
Yeah.
Now that you mention it, wasn't it snowing on Jamie's video phone call?
That's right. Their hideout has to be somewhere close to the Ina River.
The Ina River flows for miles around here, Gillian. We could never search it all in time.
Where the tube liner connects.
Let's look at a map of the areas investigated so far.
We've been over this.
This is an enlarged view of the southwest portion of the city around the Ina River. This blue area is that in which Snow 9 is present. Now I'll superimpose a chart of the abandoned tube liner tunnels.
Now we're talking.
We can establish those areas with Snow 9, which are accessible by subway tunnel.
Damn. Nice try, but it's still too large. We could never cover it in 3 hours.
Don't give up so fast, Gillian. What about that image of home thing we were talking about? Maybe there's some kind of geographic similarity. Maybe the same view can be seen or something.
I'll display a map of Moscow alongside.
Oh.
Hmm. What's this?
Why is it so familiar? So, the
look, the rivers are exactly the same shape.
Yeah, what are the odds of that?
This is the Moscow River over here.
It looks like we're on the right track, Metal. Show us the location that Jamie and I were picked up from.
All right, right here.
Metal, before the catastrophe, what was at this location?
The headquarters for the entire Soviet Union, the Kremlin.
The Kremlin? That Snatcher said something about taking Jamie to their Kremlin.
Metal, what spot in Neo Kobe would match up with the location of Moscow's Kremlin?
Calculating. This is the spot. It's presently occupied by an old church. It's rather large, but reports indicate it's been abandoned for nearly 20 years.
There's my tune.
And it's right in the middle of the Snow 9 and subway area.
That's it! That's their headquarters! Their new Kremlin!
Gillian, let's go!
Wait, Gillian. I want to go with you.
Sorry, Mika.
Hey, I'm a junker too, you know.
I know, and you're a great one at that.
So the only other one.
Take me with you, then.
You head to the summit to warn the delegates. They haven't given up, you know.
The summit's in Kyoto. I'm not going to be the only one to run.
You've got to convince them not to use nukes on Neo Kobe.
We found their hideout. There's no need now to sink the whole island.
Yes, but...
It's a tough job. Can you do it?
Okay, Gillian. I'll do what I can.
Thanks. Thank you, Mika.
Don't say it, okay?
Let's go, Gillian!
Gillian?
Yes? What's wrong?
How about dinner sometime?
Dinner?
Yeah, you know, dinner.
Mika.
Not interested. I thought it would be nice, you know, to kick back.
He
relax.
Sounds interested.
It's Christmas after all.
Christmas, huh? I'll be back by then.
Gillian, we have to hurry.
That's a promise, right? I heard you.
Yeah. Okay.
She's gonna cry.
I gotta go to church first.
Gotta go to church.
See you soon, then.
Okay, Metal. Let's go.
Let's go say our prayers. She looks like she's about to cry. This is the last turbo cycle. Okay, there's another one. How sad, right? Just two junkers left. Not including Metal Gear. The spare turbo cycle has not been painted, but that does not affect its locomotive functions. Take a careful look, please. This vehicle can only be used for another 3 hours. Why, what happens then? The parking lot has become rather lonely. We and this turbo cycle are the only things here. Let's hurry to the church. It appears quite safe. It's not been tampered with. There's nothing to worry about. I detect nothing unusual. Gillian, this is no time to be dawdling. I do not read any motions. You and I are the only ones here, blah, blah, blah. There's no one here. It's very quiet. Gillian, let's go. Not just yet. Oh, I can only save. All right. I love the song. Of course, I know the answer to that question.
I've input the map data on the Kremlin's locations. Lift off. Flight configuration. Now gaining altitude.
We're flying? That's right.
Jamie. Please be safe.
We do fly, right?
Gillian, please keep in mind that we're working with a strict time limit.
If 50-year debt in 3 hours.
That's crazy. So really...
Snow!
How old?
Snow 9, to be specific.
Yeah.
You entered the Snow 9 region. Please put on your breathing filter. Direct inhalation is dangerous.
All right.
Radio transmissions will also be impossible from this point on. Understood?
Oh boy. There's the breathing filter.
Now descending. Conversion to hover configuration complete. Gillian, we've arrived.
So we didn't have to crash the other one. We could have just flew. Right? I guess we couldn't have landed. I don't know. We've arrived at the church. Wow. Now I know why they call it their Kremlin. It's a very old church. It bears quite a resemblance to St. Basil's Cathedral. Right, the other picture. No doubt they thought the same thing. But what are the odds that the river turns exactly the same way? Except for one bit on the east end. It goes up north a little. It like branches off. I don't know. The building may be patterned after a traditional Russian church. It's quite old. It appears to be snow, but it's actually Snow 9. Try to avoid inhaling it any of it directly. I guess we have this filter on? I didn't see it happen. It's pollen, and therefore much finer than snow. It's surrounded by a large grove of tall cedar trees. This is likely to keep just about anybody away. Given the season, a few Christmas lights would really liven up the scene. I'm sure they don't care to hear about your decorating ideas. The surroundings conceal the church from all but aerial surveillance. That's another awesome theme. The building is about 50 years old, but appears very well maintained. So where's the entrance? On the front side of the building. I can see it. What's up with you, Gillian? Acid rain has seriously damaged many of the building's sculptures. This is definitely Snow 9. It's hard to believe that this much of it is present right here in the city. A sensor scan reveals that a tube liner tunnel passes directly underneath this area. Well, that's no surprise. Looks like they've got the right place. It didn't look like it intersected on the map, though, but I don't know. There's nothing in the area besides this church. I'm not reading anything at all. I'm not picking up any large movement signals. I'm not showing anything out of the ordinary. The only sound is that of the wind. It's perfectly quiet. Just us and the wind, that's all I can hear. Alright. Going inside.
Alright, now opening the door.
What's wrong? Won't open?
I've scanned it, and it's not locked. It is probably rusted into place.
Not surprising. After all, our friends always go in and out through the basement.
Right.
Let's push it together.
All right. One, two, three!
That got it.
Can't help but feel walking right into a trap. What's this? It would appear to be some kind of a chapel for the Snatchers. Wait. So we're going into a church, and we're surprised when we see church stuff. Are you telling me those things pray? To whom? No doubt to their creator. That portrait on the wall is probably a representation of him. Does it look like Gillian? Not exactly. Couldn't be Jamie, could it? With a suit? This person is no doubt the one the Snatchers worship as their creator. This guy. Isn't that random? Yep, Maude Nora backwards. Kind of forgot about that from the other episode. One moment, I'll compare the picture with my data on random. Wait. So was random the third one in the pod? So maybe random is fine? Or maybe random also had his memory erased. We don't know anything about random. Definitely not. While the facial bone structure of the individual in the portrait is nearly identical to that of random, a positive identification is impossible as the picture is not a photograph. That just looks too much like him to be a coincidence. Now that you mentioned it, the person in the portrait does look like random Hajil. Mardner, Elijah? Elijah Modnar? Some weird kind of... whatever this is. I can't even call it a song, right? These are the chairs for worshippers in a chapel, no doubt. There is no covering of dust. They appear to be used regularly. Everything is nice and orderly. It's as if the pre-collapsed Soviet Union has been recreated here. The decorations do not appear to be those of a church. Something is written on the painting. The creator, Modnar. So this is Professor Modnar? The one the Snatcher was talking about, huh? It appears to be a portrait of that person. When are they going to realize it's random backwards? I feel like this game is insulting my intelligence sometimes. Based on the condition of the paints and canvas, I would say that this portrait was painted over 50 years ago. There are a number of scratches on the surface. They were almost certainly caused by the Snatchers. When their skin isn't on. A very heavy object appears to have been placed here. It is structurally damaged. Okay. It's all very organized, almost inhumanly so. There's another room farther back. Continue back. There's no litter or garbage anywhere. It's almost too clean. I'm not reading anything at all. So have they already left for the summit? I'm not picking up any large movement signals. It's perfectly quiet. The whole area is exceptionally quiet. Except for the stupid noise. Alright, let's continue back. Now moving into the back room. It's so dark. God damn it. Hello. Snatchers! Zoinks! Look at them all. I'm not picking up any energy readings. They're all deactivated in some kind of suspension mode. So this is their warehouse, huh? There must be a few hundred of them here to continue all the way back. If we're gonna bomb any place, we'll be here. Still, this doesn't look like a factory to me. And more like a storage warehouse or something, right? My God. I didn't expect that to pop up all of a sudden. These are endostructures which have yet to have the artificial skin installed. The bone sizing devices and skull slits are all still set to the smallest sizes. So their victims haven't been chosen yet. They're all just waiting their turn. They almost look like if they could spring to life any moment. If this many snatchers were to all start moving at the same time, there's little we could do. There seem to be a number of containers stacked up in the back of the room. There's nothing of interest besides the containers. Something is written on the floor. It appears to be Russian characters from about 50 years ago. Yeah, nothing of interest, and then, oh, something of interest. What about the size of these containers? The volume of these containers should be just perfect for shipping one of the snatchers. This is no doubt how they got here. These endostructures were all shipped here in these containers. None of these snatchers appear damaged. All they need is their energy packs. The gender units have yet to be installed, however. They are all preserved in excellent condition. It appears that they undergo regular maintenance. I do not see any tools or equipment for maintaining anything in the area. This room would appear to be just a storage area. Unlike the chapel, there are some scraps and dust on the floor here. There's some kind of a label here. 23rd Siberian Investigative Force. Oh yeah, that's right. I forgot what they were writing earlier, beginning of the episode, that cutscene. They're talking about the FBI was gonna, like, take charge. But the FBI is US. We're in Japan. So I'm not sure if they realize, I mean, the US is gonna take over Japanese proceedings? Was there a Japanese FBI? It should be called something else, wouldn't it? Siberian Investigative Force? It would appear that these snatchers are brought to Neo Kobe from the Siberian Neutral Zone. Not surprising. It seems that the investigative forces have been responsible for shipping the snatchers. True. In other words, the investigative forces have been snatched just like when they found us. I see. So the Siberian Investigative Forces bring the Snatchers out of Siberia and into storage here. I think you're right, Metal. And then the Snatchers just wait here in storage to be reactivated and adjusted after their victims are selected. A rather efficient system. I wonder where the actual snatching takes place. The back part of the room may hold the answer to that question. These containers were definitely brought out of Siberia. I can detect traces of contaminants unique to the region on the containers. I'm not reading anything at all. It's perfectly quiet. Continuing back. Are you ready, Gillian? Now heading for the room farther back. Oh, I'm nervous. Oh boy.